Hi, so we just demoed the Justice AI platform, which strives to help human rights defenders navigate huge archives of evidence in order to pursue justice. And now I'm going to talk about Service Net. And that platform strives to increase equitable access to help people in need navigate huge amounts of data around social services available to them. So people need access to social services now more than ever. While these services supporting basic needs like food, shelter, financial security, etc. exist, the visibility into this social safety net is less than clear. While within a minute I can find 3, 4, 5 different restaurants that will deliver a 5-star rated pizza to my house, the same can't be said if I was a parent in search of free school supplies for my kid or someone needing to find the closest emergency shelter with available beds tonight. So where does the data about those network of social services live? I think a good way to think about it is, where might a person in need have the first touch point with the network of social services? It might be a school teacher noticing a struggling student, someone calling their local 211 referral hotline, a conversation with a nurse or a doctor when getting discharged from the emergency room, or even as pictured here, a mother and child going to a service provider like a food pantry or a homeless shelter, only to need a subsequent recommendation for a clothing bank, for instance. So on the next slide, I'm showing a diagram that on the left shows examples of those referral organizations I just mentioned, things like schools or hotlines, interfacing with people in need. Today, in order to provide recommendations, these organizations often maintain their own completely separate directories, databases, spreadsheets, or even sometimes paper binders of information about social services they're aware of in their area. On the right side of the diagram, I'm showing several examples of those social services providers themselves, such as legal aid or housing support, food banks, also interacting with people in need. These service providers also can struggle to keep a directory of all the other services in their area. And additionally, they may be getting called multiple times a day from those referrers, checking to make sure that they have the latest information or checking on availability of specific services for that day. In the center of the diagram sits Benetech Service Net, a platform that connects organizations maintaining information about social services and the social service providers themselves, allowing for real-time collaborative information about the safety net. The Service Net platform strives to make partnerships with as many of those resource directories as possible, and we build out technology to import this data, normalize the records, match them across a variety of formats, and then continuously take new updates on those records as they come in. So when I think of the vision of the platform, it's something I like to call no wrong front door. No matter where a person in need first touches the safety net, whether that's calling 211, getting discharged from the ER, visiting a homeless shelter, that front door should have access to the most complete, accurate, and quality information available in order to help that person in need go on to the next point of care. So let's jump into the platform itself. So on the homepage of ServiceNet, there's a collection of cards where each card represents an organization offering a social service. So for example, in the bottom middle here, we see a card that says the San Francisco AIDS Foundation. There's some quick high-level information, like some examples of the services they offer. So in this case, overdose prevention, housing and financial benefits, a quick indicator of the cities in which they operate. So here it's San Francisco. And then at the top here, a key section about when that record was last updated and from which database or directory it was pulled from. So this could either be the service provider themselves, or in this case, an organization like ShelterTech, who maintains a directory. What's interesting about ShelterTech is they actually work with either homeless individuals or people who have experienced homelessness to update their records, maybe giving a level of detail you'd only know if you've used the services yourself. We also partner with organizations like United Way Bay Area and even some specialized organizations like the Legal Aid Association of California, which can give us a lot of depth of information around legal services specifically that another organization might not be clear on. So on the page as well, there's some of things afforded to the users like searching, sorting, and filtering, allowing them to search by keywords, sorting by the most relevant or up-to-date records, and then filtering. So I'll open the filter pane on things like service type and geography. So for this example, I'm going to look for food donation program. So I just typed that in and selected it. And then as well, I want home delivered meals. So I'm going to select those two service types. And then for location in the city filter, I'm going to type San Francisco. So when I apply those filters, we update the records with the most relevant records to those criteria. But in addition to the card view, I'm also going to flip over to a map view. So now I'm getting a map view where each organization is represented by a pin where that location is offered. So I'm going to zoom in here and I see that, you know, let's say I have a client who's in the Haight-Ashbury neighborhood. I see a pin right in Haight-Ashbury. So I'm going to click on that pin, bringing up the card for the Haight-Ashbury food program. So I'll click into that. And this brings up a more detailed view of that program. So I get some high-level stuff around the website, email address, et cetera, the location details with the specific address, as well as a directions button to kick off a Google Maps direction search. And then for any services available there, I get a service detail card as well. So when I click into that, we get things like a description of the service, application process, eligibility, et cetera. So taking a look at this one specifically, we can see in the service description, it's a food pantry, and it says, note for coronavirus response period, food pantry continuing to operate out of the parking lot at 1525 Waller Street. New clients asked to arrive at 1 p.m. on Saturdays. Do not arrive before noon. So this is that real-time information that if your record was several months out of date, you might send someone to the wrong place or not know that they're supposed to go to the parking lot or not know that they're supposed to be there at 1 p.m. And then even more importantly, if you look at the eligibility criteria, only accepting new clients that are residents of zip code area 94117. So now, worst case scenario, someone comes to you for help and you make a referral to a food pantry that they're not even eligible to begin with. So this real up-to-date information responding to the coronavirus outbreak really helps you make sure that you're making the correct referral. So I'm going to go back to the homepage. And so in addition to pulling these records from these directories, if you're a service provider yourself, you can log into ServiceNet and either make a record from scratch to talk about the services that you offer, or if you see your record in another service directory below, you can claim that record in your own and begin to update the record within ServiceNet. So when you claim a record, it shows up at this top section here. You can click in and we see a pretty similar view to the one before, but now it's editable. So I can add and remove locations, add services, update eligibility, et cetera, in real time. And in addition, at the top here, we have the concept of a daily update. So maybe you don't want to be fiddling in a bunch of services because you just have some note or something that applies everywhere. And so right here, you could go in, provide a daily update. And when you click I'm finished, it saves that record and instantly disseminates to everyone on the ServiceNet platform. Not only to people looking for services, but then also matching back to those records from other directories, making sure that they have the most up-to-date information so they can make the most high-quality, accurate referrals. Thank you.